Hello friends, welcome to yet another episode of Youth Program Yuvavani, a composite program by members of Bambusa Library Readers. Take up one idea, make that one idea your life, think of it, dream of it, and live on that idea. Let the brain, muscles, nerves, and every part of your body be full of that idea, and just leave every other idea alone. This is the way to success. In this section, we are presenting a composite program by members of Bambusa Library Readers.
We, the Bambusa Library Readers, are pleased to welcome you to a special Yuvavani program. National Youth Day makes me wonder why. Why national and why youth? Then I found out that this day is celebrated to signify the birthday of Swami Vivekananda. Swamiji's life and the work done by him have motivated numerous organizations, study circles, and service projects involving the youth, of course. Crores of youth all over the world have been inspired by Swamiji's life and ideals and have devoted their energies for humanity's advancement. All of them could achieve their success by gathering knowledge, by extensive reading and intense study of what they read. We present for our listeners a few glimpses of such personalities and their work. When the real history of India will be unearthed, it will be proved that, as in matters of religion, so in fine arts, India is the primal guru of the whole world, as said by our Swamiji. The next presenters, Ms. Solina Khamrai and Keshilu Tayang, are really enthusiastic about expressing the same feeling as Swamiji with the Hindi patriotic song.
कदम कदम बढ़ाए जा साधना की राह पर त्याग की मशाल ले जिंदगी की राह पर कदम कदम बढ़ाए जा साधना की राह पर त्याग की मशाल ले जिंदगी की राह पर ओ भारतीय नारियों स्वधर्म का निशान उठा भूत प्रेत स्नेह से राष्ट्रदीप को जला ओ भारतीय नारियों स्वधर्म का निशान उठा भूत प्रेत स्नेह से राष्ट्रदीप को जला मातृभूमि की प्रतिज्ञ पूज्य नारी वत्सला गिर न जाए देश फिर दुर्ग की प्रवाह पर कदम कदम बढ़ाए जा साधना की राह पर त्याग की मशाल ले जिंदगी की राह पर जिंदगी की राह पर जिंदगी की राह पर
The ideal womanhood of India is motherhood. That marvelous, unselfish, all-suffering, ever-forgiving mother, one of the best role models to represent the saying is C.S. Lakshmi, also known as Ambai, a historian, a creative writer, and an independent researcher in women's studies. Her act of bravery will be expressed further by Ms. Keshilu Tayang.
Walking erect with an unfaltering gaze by Ambai. It is a memoir of the young days of the eminent Tamil writer and feminist C.S. Lakshmi, also known as Ambai, wherein she encounters her experiences of growing up in Mumbai in a Tamil family and her early struggles to become a writer during 1960s. Ambai, a historian and a creative writer, writes about love, relationships, quests and journeys in the Tamil region and elsewhere. Now, I'll read out an incident from her life which I found interesting and how the young lady stood strong and brave when she was falsely accused. I was greatly inspired by the evocative poetry of Bharati and his concept of the modern woman who walked erect with an unfaltering gaze and who was equal to man in every way. I imagined myself to be that woman who was educated, proud and a lawmaker no less than man. This woman stood for truth and justice and was not subservient to anyone. The Gandhian philosophy of simple living and high thinking also attracted me a great deal. Two of my maternal uncles were inspired by the Ramakrishna Math and its way of life and one of them joined the Math as sannyasi. After many years he came back But the philosophy of Ramakrishna and Vivekananda were not new to us children. All this gave me a righteous confidence and I had no fear of authority. When I was studying in fourth form, a teacher once accused me of talking in the class when I had not. She told me to apologize, but I told her that I could not apologize for a mistake I had not committed. She then said that if I did not apologize, I would have to stand in her class. I agreed and remained standing in her class throughout the year. During the final exam, I began to write that paper standing and she came by and told me in sheer disgust to sit down. Once in fifth form, I was sitting under a tree and reading a book in the sports period when I saw a group of teachers coming to the playground to check if girls were playing. Along with a few other girls who were also not playing, I began to play some simple game. But a class teacher had already seen me not playing. Next morning in the class, she asked, "Who were those idiots who did not play last evening?" Everyone who had not played the previous evening stood up except me. The teacher looked at me angrily and said, "Why are you not standing?" "Because I'm not an idiot, miss," I replied. She became furious and wrote in the progress report, "Misbehaving in class and also impertinent. Attention at home is much needed."
Each work has to pass through these stages: ridicule, opposition, and then acceptance, as said by our Swami Vivekananda. And to explain this even better, we have Lakili Mepong and Sakilu Chakro with a poem which would for sure inspire and motivate you all to keep moving on the path of success no matter what.
Mana halat pratikul hai, rasto par biche sul hai. रिश्तों पे जम गई धूल है, पर तू खुद अपना अवरोध ना बन, तू उठ, खुद अपनी राह बना।
माना सूरज अंधेरे में खो गया है, पर रात अभी हुई नहीं, यह तो प्रभात की बेला है, तेरे संग है उम्मीदें, किसने कहा तू अकेला है, तू खुद अपना विहान बन, तू खुद अपना विधान बन।
सत्य की जीत ही तेरा लक्ष्य हो, अपने मन का धीरज तू कभी न कहो, रन दौड़ने वाले होते हैं कायर, तू तो परमवीर है, तू तो परमवीर है, तू युद्ध कर, तू युद्ध कर।
इस युद्ध भूमि पर तू अपनी विजय गाथा लिख, जीत करके यह जंग तू बन जा वीर अमित, तू खुद सर्वसमर्थ है, वीरता से जीने का ही कुछ अर्थ है।
तू दूसरों की प्रेरणा बन, दूसरों को प्रेरित कर, क्योंकि उत्साह के बिना जीवन व्यर्थ है। तू युद्ध कर, बस युद्ध कर, तू युद्ध कर, बस युद्ध कर, तू युद्ध कर, बस युद्ध कर।
My world is what will survive, as said by Janaki Ammal, a renowned botanist from India, stuck to her these words throughout her life, inspiring the youth today. And her contributions will be highlighted by our next presenter, Ms. Solina Kamrai.
Janaki Ammal was born in 1897 to E.K. Krishnan and Devi Krishnan. Ammal most likely grew up around her father's vast library filled with books on nature and wildlife, including the two books he wrote on the birds of the North Malabar region. Janaki Ammal was a world-renowned botanist. She was the first woman to get a PhD in botany in US, first woman scientist to become a fellow at the Indian Academy of Sciences, probably the first salaried woman at the John Innes Institute, and the first woman scientist to be conferred a Padma Shri in 1977. Her life and work are an inspiration to this day, particularly encouraging to the women in science who have to struggle at various stages in their career and face a stiff challenge when it comes to having a career in science. Janaki Ammal was born in India at a time when the British ruled us and when caste discrimination was rampant. She belonged to a backward community. She faced discrimination from her colleagues and also had to face harassment due to her single status. However, she never backed down and overcame these challenges to emerge as one of the most prominent scientists of her time. She was also an active environmentalist, fighting against building a hydro power dam in Silent Valley, Kerala in the 1970s. She was greatly interested in the ethnobotany and went around the country collecting samples and interacting with the remote tribes. Despite being a top-notch scientist, Amal led a very simple and almost austere life. She was always very quiet about her life and once said, "My work is what will survive."
A role model for thousands of rural adolescent girls in Tamil Nadu, Dr. Rajammal P. Devadas. Her contributions will be discussed further by our next presenter, Ms. Bahailu Rangmang.
Rajammal P. Devadas has a lot in her bio data, some of which I would like to highlight. Dr. Rajammal P. Devadas was born on 7th April 1919 at Chengam, North Arcot District, Tamil Nadu. She was the world-renowned nutritionist who educated the importance of nutrition at infant and preschool level not only in her state but also across the whole world, and an educationist who was also a former chancellor of Avinashalingam Deemed University. And she became a member of State Planning Commission of Tamil Nadu, and she was elected as a vice president of the World Food Conference, where the government of India awarded her the fourth highest civilian honor of Padma Shri in 1992. Dr. Rajammal P. Devadas, inspired by the founder of Avinashalingam Trust and Institute for the Home Science and Higher Education for Women, Dr. T.S. Avinashalingam, who dreamed about a hunger and malnutrition free India. She became a role model for thousands of rural adolescent girls in Tamil Nadu to come out of their kitchens and strive for good and college education and change their destiny.
The art is not in making money, but in keeping it. Now, our next presenter, Ms. Manisha Halai, will express her views on managing money, the topic on financial management of the students of Arunachal Pradesh.
Like common friends, have you any time felt the need for the money for an important expenditure but not finding it with you or either with your parents? Surely, all of us have experienced this, as money shortage is not an unusual problem, but whenever we wanted money for our career building, at the time our parents are not able to give us the money. Now, this is the right time. We have to think. Some Arunachal households who are from the middle and lower income groups lack knowledge about the budget planning. All the families have abandoned money from the month of September to the month of March, where we spend it lavishly in enjoyment and entertainment. And the rest 5 months, that's the rainy season, when there is an emergency, the people remain clueless how to deal with those situations. Moreover, they struggle, and they suffer a lot. Therefore, they should learn to be like ants who are wise enough to foresee the problems ahead, and they collect the food for the tough days ahead. All people can go and meet personal finance advisor in bank. We should educate our parents about the money savings in the post office. We have financial prudence. How do we decide whether to spend the money or not to spend the money? The classification of the expenditure can be listed as, firstly, absolutely essential. Secondly, essential but not urgent. Thirdly, urgent but not the least. Alternative can be taught just once. It is, "I wish I want this item," or "enjoy this facility, but I know full inside my heart it can be waited." Such analysis before we can plan and incur an expenditure would help us as students and later in life. Even Gandhiji had kept meticulously the records of all his expenses. From that he comes to know what are the income occurrences and prioritize them, according to which we can curb all our unwanted expenditures. Instead, we can save the money. Always remember, the money saved is the money generated. We have to make our parents aware about the financial estimates. When we have less money, why not we save the money? We should teach our parents that every bit of expenditure must be jotted down. We must be a rational consumers, and financial planning for short-term and long-term goals play a very important in everyone's life in every walk of life. When we can walk, are we taking a auto, bike or scooter? When we can go by a cycle, are we taking scooter? When we can go by a scooter, are we taking the car? In a town like Tezu, perfectly we can use electric bikes, scooters and cars. Educating our parents is important, but we too have to take it as part of our life. This test is, are we spending each item money prudently? So the main takeaway from my talk are, we must set financial planning. We must make expenses records. We should educate our parents regarding different forms of saving. But last not the least, we must encourage savings to all the people. Thank you.
Now we will end the program with a song by all the presenters.
Somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly, birds fly over the rainbow, why then why can't I?
The song Rainbow signifies the importance of believing in yourself and looking deep within and asking to self, why can't I? I request all of you also, ask yourself, why can't I? To add to that, here I present a quote by Swamiji, believe in yourself and the world will be at your feet.
You are listening to a composite program by members of Bambusa Library Readers.
The Bambusa Library members who presented this program were Manisha Halai, Sakelu Chikro, Lakilu Mepong, Solina Kambrai, Keshulu Tayang, Bahailu Rangmang, and Anchor Lekhika Chakravarti.